एंड आई नीड टू नो दी लुक ऑन विच पीपीटी यू आर सो दैट अकॉर्डिंगली
इट विल बी शेयर्ड टू यू आल्सो डोंट वरी फॉर यू कैन आल्सो व्यू दैट द स्लाइड्स
या
ऑन द स्क्रीन
प्लीज लेट मी नो योर ईमेल आईडी प्लीज वंस अगेन
PRALHAD
at yahoo.com
yes.
Right, just
it's very easy.
Right now we are running off the time na shortage of time right. So
it's okay.
Yeah, just saying, just check.
Okay, I'm just checking. Not yet.
It will come. Okay, all of them are there.
Wait a moment, I'll just let you know. Total, we are 12. We are waiting for your guests.
So, shall I start in between, or let me know whether?
No, I will introduce you. Just give me 2 minutes.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I'm waiting for the PPT. Acha, guys. Minimum, je tumche yenar hote the.
I have forwarded the link, but okay. I didn't raise after that. Na, let them decide. I don't know whether exactly they are right now.
Okay. No issue. So, good afternoon, all of the LIS profession of KCO. Today we have a
good afternoon.
An eminent personality with us, Dr. Minal Oak. She is not only the librarian, she is associate with the IGNU. She also coordinates for certain training program and PGDLIM. She is also IGNU Recast committee member. Currently she is working with Mass Institute of Management and career course in Pune. She is a rank holder and a PhD holder in library and information. She is also qualified SAT, having a more than 25 years of experience, if I'm not wrong. She is in the domain of library and information science. She had awarded with many awards in library science, such as Best Teacher Award from Ajinkya D.Y. Patil University. Then she is also awarded with Best Paper Award at ManlibNet 2015. So there are a lot of awards in her profile. So she is going to discuss some part of the theoretical and some part of the theoretical. And we will go with the presentation. Ma'am, we are total 12 persons,
yeah,
all over from the India, Calcutta, Delhi, Bengaluru, and Mumbai.
Right.
Okay. I got your PPT and just downloading.
Yeah. I'm not able to visualize, but.
Wait. I'll show you.
Meanwhile, can I see the audience?
Yes. Please, on your videos.
Hello, this is Kamlesh from Mumbai.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Avi from Kolkata.
Nice to meet you.
Please introduce yourself.
Hello, ma'am.
Please let me know.
This is Rajesh.
Rajesh from Kolkata.
Right. Please do.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
This is Ankush from Mumbai.
Pleased to meet you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hi. Hello, ma'am. This is Sharvari from Mumbai.
Hello, Sharvari.
Hello, ma'am. Hello. Hello, ma'am. Bappa from the...
Yes, pleased to meet you. Hello. Yes. So how you all guys are doing?
Your slide is on.
Guys are doing in this lockdown period, let me know first. It's all tighten, right? Tighten up the schedules. And right, and in this situation, it is really encouraging that Mr. Prahlad is being some creative and innovative for you people, so to keep up you all on your toes, right? So the show must go on in the direction, and I really appreciate the efforts which are going in right direction, which will keep you mentally fit, right? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
yes, ma'am.
And you are absolutely correct.
Yeah, and what is I believe is ours field, library science field, is a practical based field, right? Every time we have to work practically. Libraries are like laboratories for us, where we can experiment n number of things in our entire career, and nobody can hold you up. If you decide something positive, something moving forward, nobody can resist your growth. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So it depends on you. As far as library field is concerned, with my experience, definitely I would like to say that it depends on your attitude, what you want to achieve in library science field. So, with this introduction, let me start with the topic, quality services and librarianship. This topic I'm going to share with you, not just theoretically, but as I told you, ours is a practical field and we require evidences. On the basis of which we work, right, in our libraries. So every time we have to create the evidences of our completed work, what exactly we are doing for our readers, what exactly they want to achieve in their life, accordingly we can provide their information needs, and which will be convenient for them to achieve the targets in their academic career, their milestones, right? So as far as this topic is concerned, it is having three major aspects. One is quality, second is service, and third is librarianship. So one by one, we will discuss what exactly is the meaning of quality, then service and librarianship. These two are very common for us. But what exactly its meaning is in the current scenario, how these are applicable and how far we can go with this librarianship concept, that we will try to discuss in this session. Next slide.
Yeah.
So this session I'm going to cover, as I told you, it's the need of service quality. Then how the libraries are transformed, various challenges faced by the library professionals as such, and what are the expectations of our management from us? What are the expectations of your users from your side? And then how can we improve the quality of our service by exactly measuring the expectation that we are going to see? And what I did in my career as far as this measurement of user satisfaction is concerned, because you are working after all for your users. Libraries are existing for the users only. So if the users are not satisfied, then definitely that will create problem for your field, for your existence. So it is required for us continuously to assess the performance of overall library as such. So that we are going to discuss. So what is the correct meaning of librarianship? Next slide. What is librarianship? Next slide. The apt meaning of librarianship, elaborated in Whale words by University of Washington, is that it's an assessment work, assessing and organizing. Please focus on the words. Assessing and organizing information to solve the information problems, right? By providing expertise service. So our expertise is the service. Service is our product, and our collection is our input, and the entire library procedures are the processing. So it is the library team where we exist. And what is the meaning? Continuously, as a library manager, you have to assess the performance. You have to quantify. You have to measure how far you are standing long way, or you are closer to your user expectations measure. What exactly is the picture? And in my view, librarianship is nothing but the management. It is an art as well as science of managing the libraries. You have to manage the entire resources. You have to manage the human manpower, right? Then apart from that, you have to manage the finances, then infrastructure, each and everything. You have to manage your users in a positive way so that they will get the required information effectively and efficiently as per their expectation, not in your eyes. As per their opinion, it must be at par. And that is nothing but the assessment. And this assessment we have to do for what? For the results. For getting the results. Any management process is always focused on results. So like the library is nothing but a system. So when we work in a system, it must be focused on results. So what is the target of you in this complete year? Your corporate library and many branches you are having all over in India. So what is your target? What is the common goals, or at least your personal goal in your job where you are working? Are you setting the targets for you? Are you measuring the performance of your users or your users' eyes? That we have to judge. So what we have to assess next? What we have to assess? This we have to assess. That's what I told you just. What we have to assess? We measure the expectation. Assessment is what? Measuring. What is the expectation of your users? What is the perception of your users regarding the service which you are providing? And what is their minimum acceptance level? That below that level, they will not accept you at all, right? And if they are not satisfied, what is exactly the gap exist in between, right? So this is the correct meaning of service industry. Any service industry, if you observe hospital, or say hotel industry, they are on toes continuously and they are striving hard to achieve the result. You have to chalk out the milestones of your user satisfaction and you have to move accordingly, because for everything we require long range and short range planning. Without that, we cannot move ahead. So why there is a need of quality library service? when the word we use quality, right, it indicates a lot. When we use a single word quality, because quality is something which you cannot show, right? Can you show the quality when we are in service industry? No, because physical existence. For example, nano car exists physically. We can take a test drive and check the quality of nano easily by sitting in nano car. Anytime, all over in the world, anybody can judge the quality of nano product because of the physical existence. It is not the case with service industry. Because of the intangible nature, you cannot quantify, you cannot see it physically. That's why it is very difficult to measure the service. Even though there are few tools with the help of which you can measure. So how we can measure that we will see. But when we use word quality, it indicates you what? It indicates you what? It indicates you the standards, right? It indicates you standards as well as it indicates you the certain benchmark. What do you mean by quality? For example, when you say Tata or say any certain names, Dabur. So what it indicates? It indicates brand image in your mind. Tata or Dabur, these are nothing but, or Hyundai, these are nothing but the brand images. It carries brand along with it. And they did so many things or a lot of efforts to create this brand, right? So this is the quality. And it is highly difficult in service industry to measure. But we need to measure it to show the performance, to achieve the user satisfaction. Now, as far as when we link up this word quality with that next slide, transformation in libraries, when we link up this quality word to libraries, we observe that libraries are being evolved continuously, right? Earlier, few years back, we have witnessed the traditional libraries where the users visited physically to access the physical material. And for getting information, definitely physical visit was essential. Then earlier to that, historical libraries were there, like museums. Again, physical visit in those days was essential to get the information. And now we are living, next slide, in hybrid libraries. We are witnessing these hybrid libraries where the non-print medias are completely dominating on our print. And definitely we are also spending a lot of amount of our budget on this non-print, e-resources, on subscribing e-resources than to print. Our users, definitely they are using palm tops, laptops, right? And even the Akash tab is very famous of IIT, which is very well used by the even the students of technology in all over India. So many databases are entered. So in this scenario, what exactly has happened? It is definitely become difficult to measure the quality of service in this changing scenario. Because what has happened? The information is available in number of documents. Various types of documents are there which can provide you the information. Not only the e-journal, but information can be in e-books. Even it can be in print books. It can be in the, even a fax can contain valuable information. So number of documents are there where you have to search to retrieve the particular information because of the tremendous impact of ICT. Next slide, please. Impact of ICT. It's because of the tremendous impact savvy nature of our users. And it has resulted, number three, it has resulted in increased user expectations. The expectations from you of users from the libraries is tremendously, it has been extended. Expecting so much things from the libraries apart from the print information. And our role is obviously extended. And certain sustainability issues, number four, which we are witnessing due to the competitors, these computer science people, as well as the online vendors, these are our close competitors, right? Which has created the sustainability issues for the libraries. But I will answer this sustainability issues lastly. So this is nothing but next slide. The impact of ICT. I think there is no need for me to go in deep in these ICT details. We all are using, we are aware with the library softwares, then all the technologies which we are using, blogs and resource sharing concept, which is reshaped in the form of consortia. And because of the open access movement, again, it has changed the world. It has changed the information world rather. And the libraries are being consistently insisted to create their own information commons. Are you aware with this information common idea? Hello?
Information. Hello?
Are you aware with the information commons in audience? Anybody? Otherwise, I'll inform and then we will go on. Information common is nothing but the slogan. They are having a slogan, what you need, we will provide. For example, many of the American universities or even in Australia, they have created nice information commons. And what exactly they are doing, right from the coffee, right from the restroom, right from the exercise room, and even the laptops or accessibility notes, all the facilities they are providing under one roof in the library itself. And what you need, they are ready to provide. And in this way, alternatively, what they are doing, they are increasing the use of their reading halls and libraries. Hello? Hello? I think somebody is not able to hear.
Hello?
Hello?
Avaaz yetoy ka sarvanna?
Somebody is saying she is not able to understand.
No, everyone is getting voice, I guess. Sharvari, avaaz yetoy na?
Yes, I am able to hear.
Haan, sarvanna yetoy. Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, if somebody is not able to hear or somebody is not able to understand, please let me know. Okay. Yeah. This is about the information commons because this is an interactive session. Otherwise, there is no any meaning. Na?
Yeah.
So, we are now moving towards the expectations. The librarianship concept, we discuss. Now, the next is quality service. What exactly is the meaning of quality service and how to provide the quality service in or through that we are going to focus. So as far as librarianship is concerned, what is the nature of quality service? What is the ultimate aim of our quality service to user satisfaction? Next slide, please.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
That's fine.
So, right. So, the quality service, the ultimate aim of quality service is in librarianship is to achieve the user satisfaction. Why we are doing all these things? Why we have to improve the service quality to satisfy ultimately our users? And of course, it will be value to your organization, right? It will help you to create your own brand. And even to handle the sustainability issues so that users will be attracted towards the library and they will use the library as much as they can with the full interest.
Yes, ma'am.
Next slide. So these are the common problems which current library professionals are facing. If we have to improve the library service, by using the quality parameters, click again and again, Pralla.
Yes.
So that we can measure our service, and the ultimate aim is to exceed the expectations of our users. If they are demanding four level service from you, you have to exceed their expectation. You have to provide by using standard 5 to your service, so it will go beyond their expectation. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
So the libraries are existed as a stimulant and satisfying the professional requirements. Next slide.
That's it?
Right. So as a stimulant, libraries are working to satisfy the professional requirements. Next.
Yes.
So what we need today? Right. Today we need a dynamic librarian. We have to accept the challenges which are enforced due to the several changes in the world and happening case of the library. We should adopt and adapt accordingly. We should mold ourselves as per the needs of our users to achieve their maximum satisfaction. Next slide.
Next
to that.
You want to take this one?
Next two slides. Go ahead, two slides.
Right?
Correct. So, what is the meaning of service? We are providing library service continuously. But when we are looking service from the management point of view, what is the exact meaning of service? It is given by Philip Kotler, the marketing guru, has written the meaning of service in 2000 only. And what is his opinion? Service is an act or performance that one party can offer to another and which is essentially intangible. So when you are offering service as your product, it must be highly intangible in nature, right? This is the first characteristic of any service. Does not result in the ownership of anything. Suppose Prahlad is providing service to one of the major lawyer, your user. After providing service, can he mention that it is his service? Can you mention, Prahlad?
No.
No. Because service, you cannot label it by your ownership, which is not the case with the product industry. For nano car, ownership is there. For everything, each and every physical product, label is there. Without label, they are not going to market the thing. Only in case of service, ownership is a big issue. So, what happened because of that? So many issues we are facing. Are we facing because of this ownership issue? Number of issues we are facing, we are handling, right? As a librarian.
Yes.
Its production may or may not be tied to a physical product. It can be tied to a physical product or it cannot be. Not necessary. So this is the exact meaning of service in terms of management. Next.
Yes,
now, what is quality? What is quality? We have seen librarianship. We have seen service. Now, what is quality? Quality is what? Totality of the features and characteristics of a product or service that bear on its ability to satisfy stated or implied needs. Means what? See, you have to achieve the minimum standard if you want to satisfy your users' needs. For example, all these IEEE 1000 or say NAC, NBA, all these minimum level standards which we always we are viewing it as maximum, right? But these are the minimum you have to achieve if you want to satisfy your audience. And whenever we are mentioning certain product is of high quality, what we mean, what is the parameter to know whether a product is of high quality and certain product is of low quality? What does that mean? It means that whenever we mention the product is of high quality, definitely it is meeting or going beyond the expectations of the user. So right. Always a product is judged from the eyes of the customers, not from the eyes of the providers. Next slide.
Yes.
Now we are going to see the meaning of service quality. What is the meaning of service quality? See, in the slide, first see the second bullet. What is the bullet point? Service quality is nothing but it is the measure of how well the delivered service matches the customer expectations. Your customers are expecting XYZ thing and you are delivering something vague, ABC to them. So it is not going to match. So what is the purpose of service quality? To see, to actual measure what exactly you are providing and what your customers are expecting from you. It is known as service quality measure. Now focus the first bullet. Service quality is a matter of knowing your customers. Obviously, when you are going to measure your service, you are analyzing your customer expectation, definitely you will try to know your customers in a deep sense. And you will design the services accordingly after that, because you will realize what are the gaps. You have to deliver for getting their maximum satisfaction. Next slide.
Next slide.
Next slide.
Next slide.
So, user satisfaction is what? User satisfaction is what? When you add quality to your service, it becomes user satisfaction. Right?
Right.
Next slide. Next slide.
Okay.
So, previous.
Okay, sorry.
Right. So, in this expectation, what actual we are witnessing in practice in our library world, what we are experiencing, that actual experience of our users is something different, right? And they are expecting you another thing, and many times it happens that you are giving some other thing. I am not talking about the books only. Level of expectation. See the level of expectation. They are expecting certain level of service and you are giving below to that. And it affects on what? It affects on their satisfaction. How many factors are affecting on this user satisfaction? How can you study? Because of the effective accessibility they are having, it is affecting their satisfaction level. So their level of satisfaction is now today is increased, right? Tremendously. Expectation level is increasing and it is affecting their satisfaction level. Next, the remaining factors we have seen. So I'm not going again in that.
Should I go ahead?
No, that is okay. Keep it only. Now, we see the historical